तीसरी नंबर 365 5 सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट। मिस्टर डिप्टी स्पीकर सर, आई थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग मी टाइम टू स्पीक इवन एट दिस लेट आवर। आई एम सपोर्टिंग द डिमांड्स ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फूड एंड सिविल सप्लाइज। दिस मिनिस्ट्री हैज़ द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी to provide food to the people all over the country, and I am happy to say that it is discharging this responsibility efficiently. The public distribution system has a great role to play in controlling the prices of essential commodities. This is one of the important items in the Prime Minister's 20-point program. It is the duty of the government to provide food at fair prices to the people, and the policy of the government is to open fair price shops in all nooks and corners of the country. I find that the number of fair price shops has steadily gone up over a period of time. For example, in 1999 we had 3 lakh fair price shops, which have increased to 4 lakhs in 2007. 78% of these shops are in the rural areas, which shows the government's concern about the people in the rural areas. But in this context, I want to draw the attention of the government to the complaints that many things are not available in the fair price shops in the rural areas. Therefore, the government must monitor the distribution of the food grains which it supplies. Another point I want to make in this connection is that the government should increase the number of items distributed through the fair price shops. For example, pulses are very essential for nutritious diet. Therefore, pulses should also be distributed through fair price shops. The central government has a scheme to provide financial assistance to the Civil Supplies Corporation in northeastern states, Sikkim, Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, etc., for the construction of godowns. There was a demand for Kerala for similar aid, but it has not been considered. Therefore, I would request the Honorable Minister to consider favorably the request from the Kerala Civil Supplies Corporation for assistance to construct godowns in the state. It is one of the most important duties of the Department of Food and Supplies to control the prices of essential commodities. I must say in this context that there has been very heavy price in rice, respect of fruits and vegetables throughout the country. The government must make adequate arrangements to sell fruits and vegetables through consumer shops and other outlets. This problem is very acute in cities taking advantage of cold storage facilities. The big wholesalers store these items and retail them bit by bit into the market and make huge profit. There is a monitoring cell in the civil supplies department, but more effective steps will have to be taken to control the prices. Now, I come to some of the problems of my state, Kerala. The distribution of rice and palm oil is not being done properly in the state. This is causing a lot of problems to the public. This only shows that the state government is not managing the distribution properly. It is not enough that they get supplies. Fair distribution has also to be ensured. That is the duty of the state government, which is not being discharged by that government. However, I take this opportunity to demand that Kerala should be given 2 lakh tons of rice and 10,000 tons of palm oil per month and adequate quantity of kerosene and sugar should also be supplied. I would also request the government to see whether the food grains and other items supplied by the center are being distributed properly. There is a tendency in the present left front government in Kerala to mismanage the distribution and put the blame on the center. So the central government should be very vigilant about it. Similarly, under the present practice, 50% of the ratio is subsidized by the center. I have a suggestion to make in this regard. This subsidized ration should be supplied to them at a time. Otherwise, they are not in a position to buy it, and the shopkeeper will take all the benefits of the subsidy. The public distribution system in Kerala has been widely acclaimed, but the state government is not doing anything to strengthen it. This is evident from the fact that the state government has made only a very small token provision in the budget for public distribution system. This is a politically motivated step, because if the public distribution system fails, they can always put the blame on the center. I would therefore request the center to meet fully the requirements of Kerala for food grains and other essential commodities like kerosene and edible oil, and strengthen the public distribution system in that state. I would also request the Honorable Minister for Food and Civil Supplies to take steps to monitor the distribution effectively. I once again support the demand of the Ministry of Food and Civil Supplies, and with these words I conclude.